Hello and welcome to the BP Wealth page. My name is Yuvraj Ashok Thakkar, and today I'm going to really simplify algo trading for you. Many people have many videos about this topic, me as well, but they're far too complicated for no rhyme or reason. I really want to make this video as simple and informative as possible so that you enjoy it as much as we do. We want you to understand the strategy building process, the infrastructure, and the execution process so that by the end of this video, you will have a decent understanding of what it takes to build and run strategies that are automated. All right, let's start from the beginning. What is an algo? Algorithmic trading is a system of trading which automates either the decision making or the execution or both, based on conditions defined by you, the user. These can be as easy or complex as you desire. The most important thing to remember is that the computer is a dumb machine that will follow any and all instructions that you give it. It is up to you to be as smart as possible to create a winning strategy that gives good returns. The only way to do this is by constantly reading, learning, researching, and testing out new ideas. There is often a misconception when it comes to algorithms. People often confuse strategy with execution. People often think that these are black boxes that make money. This is not true. It is the same as human trading, except it is faster, unemotional, rule-based, and very scalable. Let us first begin by examining the benefits that you can get from an automated trading system versus manual trading. Primarily emotion. Auto trading has no bias. It does what you tell it to do, and it is very systematic, whereas manual trading has a lot of discretion, gut feeling, market reading. So there are many other elements that come into manual trading. Secondly is the speed. A system can trade many times in 1 second, whereas a human being cannot. The third difference is customizability. You can customize a machine to read many different layers of data, many different price points, many different factors, whereas a human being can only consume a limited amount. And the fourth and the most important part of all of this is scalability. A machine can scan unlimited number of stocks to find a perfect trading opportunity, whereas a human being cannot do that. Okay. Now that you have a decent understanding of the basics, let's dive into the process of actually building an algo. Step one is the strategy building process. This is the most important process of the entire exercise, as it will directly result in the profitability or the loss of your trading strategy. The more time and effort that you spend here, and the better you are at strategy building, the more money you will make, and there will be lesser chances for losing money due to unforeseen circumstances. It all begins with an idea. You can either start with an idea based around something that you've noticed in the market, something that you've observed, technical analysis, fundamental analysis, quantitative analysis, behavioral finance. There are many studies in finance, physics for example, that you can apply to create the basis of a trading strategy. The next step is collecting data. You want to ensure that your data is clean, accurate, and has all the elements that you need to test it. The next step is strategy creation. This is where your idea starts becoming a strategy. You input the parameters of your trading strategy into the data, which basically means you decide when you will buy and when you will sell. We do this using many of the tools available, like Excel, AMI Broker, R, MATLAB, or any other free software available online. This is essentially called a backtest. What you want to learn in this step is, one, how many times did your strategy trade? Two, how many times were those trades profitable? Three, how many times did the strategy lose money? And four, how much profit did you make at the end of the year? After getting these results, we will fine-tune our strategy to increase the number and the amount of profitable trades, and obviously reduce the number of loss-making trades. The professionals spend most of their time on this step, and they get very creative to try to increase the alpha that they generate on this step by making minor tweaks, but all of them add up. A few things to remember about backtesting. One, usually the longer time period you test for, the better output of your results, because you have captured more market cycles. Secondly, not all stocks behave the same. So you will have to backtest on every different stock that you want to run your strategy on. And thirdly, and I cannot state this enough, risk management is extremely important. Do not trade without understanding when your system will lose money, in what scenarios it underperforms, and how much money you will lose. Most algo platforms have risk management tools that help you manage your own risk, but you need to be honest with yourself and you need to understand how much risk it is that you personally can take and how much money you can lose on a losing trade. Now, on to the battlefield. Now, let's take the strategy that you've created into the live market. For that, you will need to understand the infrastructure required to host a live algo. Most algo platforms are built in the following fashion. There is usually a graphic interface or a computer screen that you will input your strategy, parameters, and risk adjustment. Next comes a CEM, or the Complex Event Management System, which is basically just a fancy way of saying a piece of software that understands your strategy and then watches the market to decide when to trade or when not to trade. And third, finally, there is the OMS, or the Order Management System. This enables your entire algo to speak to the market. Obviously, this is an oversimplification, and there are many other steps that go into building the platform and the algos, but we'll leave that for another video. Feel free to comment any questions that you have below, and I'll do my best to answer them. Also, comment any suggestions for topics that you want us to cover. Please subscribe and hit the bell so that we know you're enjoying this, and we'll keep making videos like this. Thank you very much, and happy investing.